Okay, good morning. We'll start now. Wait lang. Listen po yung aking slides.
Good morning, ma'am.
Okay, good morning. Okay, so our discussions will be about the module 4. So take note, ah, your final exam will be on the second week of June. So therefore, I guess there will be last module. So yung last module natin, no? Wait lang, ah. Okay. So this will be, I mean, second to the last topic. So instead of giving you three more modules, so I'm thinking baka di na kaya ng ating schedule. So baka one or two more modules na lang. Titingnan ko muna yung isang module kung kukonti lang yung topic so I can insert the other module. Okay? So for the module 4, since we're already late kasi dapat unit 2 na yung i-discuss ko since because of the may time yun, no? Isang day kahit yung pagkahapon ay wala pa rin internet, so we haven't meet within a week nung last week, I guess. So paspasan ko lang to yung ating module 4. It's all about hardware. So we're done with the software and now we're in the hardware. Actually, the activity, the elaborate activity was already posted kahapon pa, no? I mean, kagabi pala. That will be your activity for this module 4. Okay, so i-discuss ko yan later on kung how you will answer it and ano pa yung makikita natin dito. And then for the laboratory activities for module 4, give me until this week, no? After I upload the laboratory activities for module 4, i-upload ko na din yung I'm still on the process of getting topics for your Google Slides, okay? I already gave you pala, no, yung ating laboratory activity sa ating Google Docs and Sheets. Okay, i-discuss ko muna. I mean, I don't know if I already discuss it. Diniscuss ko na ba yun how you will answer the Google Docs and Sheets? Okay, I guess hindi nyo alam kasi hindi nyo alam how you will answer it, yes or no ba? You're blank on what I am talking about. Okay. So, pupunta na lang tayo sa ating classroom. Okay, Bravo 1. Okay, in your classwork, you can find there. So, nandito na yung ating activities, no, for this week topic. So, wait lang, no? Sana yung module 2. So, in Google Docs, you just click it. No, pag-click natin, mendandan po yung ating mga activities. So, 20 points worth po yung mga activities na to. So, you don't need anymore to share. Yung sinasabi ko sa inyo, share the link. So, I'll look for another way wherein I'm the one who will giving you the format and then you just turn in sa akin. Okay, for example, no, gagawin niyo na po yung ating Google Docs activity number 1, 2, 3. Ito dito. Ito yung acting activity 4 and this one will be your activity 5. Dito sa taas is your Google Sheets. That will be your activity. Wait lang ha. Dalaki ko para medyo klaro siya. So, no, nandito sa baba yung ating activity. Wala pa pong nag-turn in. So, ganun po yan. So, open ko mo. Pag open nyo, ah, take note, the deadline for this is May 23. Okay? Sa the Google Docs and the Google Sheets. So, you don't need any more to create. We just open it up and then you just edit. Like, you put your name, year and section. Well, hindi na po kailangan i-edit sa activity 1. Ito din hindi na kailangan i-edit. Ang edit na natin is the date. And kanino po natin isusulat yung personal letter. For example, sa nanay natin, dear mom, or dear pop, or dear ate, dear kuya, whatever. Or yung mga crush natin dyan, or girlfriends, boyfriends, gusto nyo isulat ng personal letter. Okay, this one is your content, so you just edit this one. Okay, the content can be anything about na gusto nyo sabihin sa ating personal letter. Okay, your loving, example, kung sa nanay, your loving son. And then your name. Nandito po yung ating note. Make the content of your letter justified. Oh, so therefore, ito ay i-justify po natin, no? So, you know where to look for the justification. Okay? So, pag ninanap na po natin yung justifications, yun po ang ating gagawin, no? Hanapin nyo po, ito po yung magiging aking criteria. Is your letter justified? If not, so minus points. Your name should be bold. So, i-bold po natin the name. And then, you're capitalize. So, you all know where to make it bold and capitalize. Okay? Next is the newsletter. So, type your name again, your year and section. So, ito, retain it. So, create a newsletter. So, this one, i-edit, tanggalin yan. This will just be your guide on what to do. So, for example, sinabi dito, no? Yung font style is Oswald 24 bold blue color and center align for the title. What will be your title? Your title is about, your title will be your full name. Katulad nito, this will be an example, no? Your title, yung full name nyo, and you will talking about yourself. Sabi nyo lang, Babelia Calago, born, blank, 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 sabi mo, a daughter of sino yung parents nyo, the eldest daughter among the ilan kayo lahat, ganyan. So any everything about yourself, your likes, your skills, anything. And then you insert a picture of yourself. Kailangan yung picture natin na hindi yung walang damit. Okay? So ang hindi naman kailangan naka-formal, basta meron lang siyang damit, okay? So 3 columns, no? The topic of yourself mabis 3 columns. So, ibig sabihin, ganito ang ang tatlong column. So, if ever it's, you didn't follow the pattern, it's not in a 3 column, minus points. Yun po ang aking criteria dito. Ito po ang iti-check ko kung you follow the procedure. Okay? So, this is the example. I gave you the example also. Okay, for the activity, same name, your section, greeting card, retain. We just remove this one and so with the example. So, this is the example of greeting card. So, you can insert pictures or anything na gusto nyo isend yung greeting cards nyo. So, you can customize the content. Kayo na pa ho bahala sa paggawa ng inyong greeting card. Okay, so those is for the activity 1 to 3. The activity 4 is your resume. Okay, I forgot to mention, no? Go back, no? So, everything na ginawa natin, pag tapos na po tayo, you just click the turn in. As unfortunately, hindi nyo na makikita yung turn in dito because I'm the one who create the doc. So, therefore, wala po ako makikita ang turn in. Pero since kayo po yung estudyante ko, may lalabas po ng turn-in dito sa site ni Share. Okay? So, may turn-in po dito sa taas. after, take note, pag natapos na po lahat, I mean, natapos na itong docs 1 and 2, 3, magta-turn in na po kayo. Pero pag hindi pa kayo natapos, wag muna, okay? Kasi pag na-turn in na yan, hindi na po pwede i-edit. Okay? Kasi, for example, gusto nyo gawin na naman pagkabukas, hindi nyo naman muna ito gagawin, edi pwede nyo lang i-close yung inyong browser. Huwag nyo muna i-edit. And then, i-open nyo lang uli. Tapos lalabas na yung saan kayo natapos nung last time. Okay? Pero, pag natapos na kayo, please look for the turn in beside the share ata and then click it. Dapat i-click ang turn in para alam ko na nag-pass na kayo. Okay?
And then, hi, ma'am.
No, kasi dito ay wala pang na-turn in. Oh, as you can see, wala pa siya ng turn in. 17 were assigned but nobody yet turned in. So, ibig sabihin gumagawa pa. Okay, so sa resume, so the same pa rin no sa resume, we just click the docs and then, di ba sinabi ko, edit nyo lang ito and then insert your picture, edit ito and everything here, edit. Okay? So, wala po akong procedure. Just follow the format and then edit. And then, after you do it, click turn in. Okay? So, same with the last activity. So, ito ang mga activity ay medyo, hindi naman siya sobrang complicated nor sobrang easy. Average lang naman. It will just give you your, use your time mostly. Okay? So just type your name, where you are, where your streets, your city, etc. Edit. Okay, tapos dito, yan po ang edit. Wag na i-edit si 4th September. So we're just assuming, no? We're just assuming na we're in the September 4, okay? So depende na po anong year yan. So ito, wag na i-edit because this is a fixed name because you're writing your resume, your letter. Your application letter to the managing staff of Magsaysay Company. Okay? So, this one, wag na yan edit. Ang edit po natin ay this one. So, ano po ang procedure natin? Sinabi dito, first paragraph, state the purpose of your letter. Name the position. Oh, meron siyang nilagay, no? So, you just answer, what is the purpose of your letter? I am applying for the vacant position. Example, name the position type of work for which you are applying. I am applying for a chief engineer position in your company. O yan. Second paragraph, state why are you applying and how you are you qualified. O yan, just answer yung binigay kong guides dyan. So sabihin nyo lang, I am applying for this position because I am qualified. I have a license, chief engineer, blah, blah, took plus mga ganyan. Assuming na lang na kuha nyo na. So, specify nyo anong date, anong year nyo kinakuha ang inyong license. Tapos, sabihin nyo yung experience nyo. I'm also a chief engineer in Allison Shipping Company last, blah, 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 ganyan. I'm a graduate of BS Marine Engineering in Zamboanga Peninsula Polytechnic. Zamboanga Peninsula Polytechnic State University last ganyan. So assuming lang, no? So just explain everything dito. I-answer lang. Closing paragraph. Sasabihin nyo, if you have any questions or queries about my credentials, you can email me or you can contact me at my cell phone number, blah blah blah. Ganyan. Tapos, last one, write a brief expression. Thank you for your time and hoping to be part of this prestigious company. Mga ganyan. So, ganun lang po ang gagawin. Yes, Cadet Almuk. Wait, hindi talaga na kompleto yung Almuk ba to? Almuk Sar ba yan? You raise your hand. May question ba? Cadet?
Meron, ma'am.
Hi, what's your question?
Regarding sa resume, mag-attach pa ng photos po?
Yes, you're going to attach your photos beside your name. Yung kanina, may name doon, tapos lalagay nyo lang yung picture natin.
Hi, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, welcome. Okay, so after this one, sasabihin na natin, sincerely, your signature. O, paano ko, ma'am, paano ko ilalagay yung signature ko? Gawin nyo sa papel, picturean, and then the daughter, insert, image, upload from computer or upload from cellphone yan, lalabas yan. So, lalagay nyo lang po yung ating signature dyan. Okay? And then your name. Okay, take note. Oh, my note. Make the content of your letter justify so you know how to justify. I already discussed this one last meeting. Your name should be bold and capitalized. Saan yan yung name? Ito po. Bold po yan, then capitalized. Anong ibig sabihin capitalized? All capital letter. Okay? So, after you do this, click turn in. Turn in can be found dito sa upper right beside the share. Okay? So, that's all for the Google Docs. Now, we go to the Google Sheets. So, sa Google Sheets, meron lang kayong dalawa, activity. So, same pa rin yung ginawa ko, no? 50 points for this one and 50 points for this one. So, medyo mas malaki yung puntos ni Google Sheets kay Docs. It's because you're doing the formula. Okay. Just click it. The same lang. Di nung na kailangan i-share yung sa akin yung link. Ako na po ang gumawa para mag-edit na lang kayo, then turn in. Okay? So, meron dito. Just type your name, your section, activity number one, huwag na galawin yan. Okay, yung turn in ha, dito lang sa site, sa share. Okay, anong gagawin ko dito? Yan, pera. Ano sinabi dito? Make the title such name, title yan, no? Make the title such as the name of employee, position, etc. to bold, center, font size, font color, font style. O, yan. So, ibig sabihin, ito daw, lahat, gagawin nyo font size 14, font color blue, font style is Georgia. And this one, ito. Ang gagawin dyan, make the name of employees, font size 14, color is red, style is Comic Sun MS. Okay? Now, use the formula below. So, we have here the formula. Anong sinabi? Pera must be in 1,000 pesos each. So, 1,000 pesos. Yan. Isusulat mong 1,000. So, tingnan nyo ha. 15 employees. You write all 1,000. Diba? I already taught you on how to do the copy and paste, point and click. So, ang gagawin ko is point and click. So, point and click, yung arrow ko is, yung arrow ko yan dyan, no? Pag pumunta dito sa point, nagiging cross. Okay? Take note, ha? Pag pupunta dito sa point, nagiging cross. And then, you click this one, drag it. Huwag mag-release. Automatic po, lalabas si 1,000. And then, just add additional pesos para 1,000 na siya. 0.00. Ayan. So, alam natin yung total, no? The total can be found the summation. Dito sa summation, yan. I already taught that. Okay. Salary loan. O, saan siya salary loan? O, yan si salary loan. So, si bookkeeper ay 667. So, hanapin si bookkeeper. Yan si bookkeeper. So, 667 daw. O, kaya na mag-a-add niya, no? Andyan yung mga formula. If you have question, just PM me. I already taught this one on how to do it last week. Okay? Then after you do it, dapat kompleto na yan. May mga answer yan dito. Then, do the totals. May mga answer din yan dito sa baba. After that, then click turn in. Ano lang po yung gagawin natin sa activity. Okay?
Ma'am, bonus, ma'am. Isa lang, ma'am.
Anong bonus? Ah? Wait. Andiyan na, naka-bonus na yan. 1,000, oh. Ngayon, nandito, ah, life and retirement. Ang formula is equals basic salary times 8.5%. So, dito, no? Life and retirement start with equals. Saan yung si basic salary? Sinabi ko, i-click nyo lang si basic salary, i-times, then 8.5%. And then, click drag and drop. Ganyan lang. Okay, same with the Google Sheets Activity 2. Ganun lang din ang gagawin nyo, no? Just type the name, your section, yan. Make the title of the school and its address center and change the font style you want and the color. So, kayo na po ang bahala. Ito yun ang sinasabi. Gagawin mo daw center. So, paano yung sinabi ko center? Diba? Ang center, hanggang dito man siya, no? Gagawin nyo is merge cells. Para center siya. Ayan. Tapos, pupunta si center. Ayan. Diba? Naka-center na. Kasi, pag dimoretso ka sa center, ayan. Hanggang dyan lang yan siya. Kasi isang cell pa lang siya. Pag merge mo lahat, pupunta talaga yan sa center. Okay? So, naka-bonus ka na dyan. Ayan. Ngayon, use the formula. Same pa rin. PhilHealth is, saan si PhilHealth? Ayan. Equals if. So, type equals if, open, basic salary, click si basic salary, yan, si 11,000, less than 3,000, comma, 20, comma, 37.50, then, close parenthesis, then, enter. So, ganyan lang po. Just copy all the formula, i-change lang po yung word na basic salary. Kasi si basic salary, hindi po yung word. Kundi, it's talking about the basic salary of Baños. Okay? If you're doing this row of Baños. But if you're doing this one, you're talking about the basic salary of Hill. Okay? And then after you do that, you just click the turn in this portion. Wala kasi akong turn in kasi I'm the one who make the activity. Okay, so those are the laboratory number 2. Sa Google Slides, I'm still thinking of the topics. Hinahanap ko pa. Hindi ko pa makita. Okay? Now, time check is 10 o'clock. So, give me 1 hour more for the module 4. So, paspasan ko lang yung module 4, no? Okay. Sa module 4, we're talking about hardware and systems technology basics. So, the course outcome for this one is to evaluate computer network use on board ships in terms of modularity and expandability. Yan, no? So, we're done with this one. I already uploaded this one last weeks ago. For you to have knowledge regarding computer hardware. Okay, so this is the four basic computer functions. So, yun po yung gagawin nyo later, no? Dito sa ating Google... Wait, ah. Nandito na yun. Yan. Dito sa ating activity, no? Yan po yung activity nyo. So, just type your name. So, in your own words... Explain the flow of the four basic functions. Ay, bakit pala itong picture? Wait. How come wala itong picture? Saan yung mga picture ko? Ah, baka nag-loading pa siya. Okay, I might... Computer is still loading, kaya wala siyang picture. Wait lang natin, no? So, antayin natin yung pictures dito. So, bale, may pictures. In your own words, explain the flow of four basic computer functions. 10 points po yan. So, bale, ito po yung explain natin. Yan. So, bale, papasok po yan dito. And then, you explain it. So, in your own words. So, you can use examples and anything. And then, type nyo lang po dito yung answers nyo, then click next. Okay? So, later on, yung isa naman, i-discuss ko, naga-loading pang aking activity dito. Okay? So, Ayan, no? So, sinabi dito, this is your hardware, and this is your software, and these are the peopleware. So, these are the three main components of the computer. Hardware, software, and peopleware. And who do you think is the most important components? Is it the hardware, the software, or the peopleware? Actually, obviously, it's the peopleware. Because yung hardware ay hindi mag-exist asaka yung software pag wala ang tao. Because human being is the one who create the designs of the computer, who create the different softwares, di ba? So, without this, so that's why peopleware is the most important component. Kaya, most important component of a computer system. Okay, so pupunta na po tayo sa ating hardware. Okay, so hardware is the collection of all parts of you can physically touch. The software is a set of instructions for a computer to perform specific operations. And software can only be found inside our computer or in our cell phone. Yung mga nakikita natin Facebook, Messengers, etc., those are the softwares. At makikita lang po yan siya sa loob ng ating computer hardware. Okay, so there are two types of computer, the desktop and the laptop. So tingnan niyo yung difference ng desktop, no? Ang laptop, lahat ng components na ito ay naka-insert na. I mean, naka-built-in na sa isang laptop. Unlike sa desktop, separate yung monitor, separate yung CPU, separate yung keyboard, and separate po yung mouse. So, kailangan nyo pa ng wire to connect them all. Okay? Meron ding wire, may wire, meron ding walang wire. Okay. So, there are types of peripheral devices. So, yung mga definition sa escape ko na yan. Kayo na pong magbabasa niyan. Yung important lang hindi discuss ko. Okay, so there are types of peripheral devices. So, di-discuss po natin yan, no? The three categories of the peripheral devices are input, output, and storage. Bakit hindi nakasama si processing device? It's because processing device is already part of the computer. Itong input, output, and storage, pwede lang po tayo magdagdag. Kaya na tinawag na peripheral. Peripheral is a device that is connected to a computer but is not part of the core computer architecture. That is why, for example, pag meron kang desktop computer. So, si desktop computer ay mostly wala pong microphones, speakers, and camera. Unlike yung laptop, meron siya. So, this, kaya nga, tinatawag na peripherals kasi bibili pa po kayo ng speaker. Bibili pa kayo ng microphone, ng headset, ng webcam, mga ganyan. So, they are considered to be a peripheral devices. Okay? So, we have types of hardware devices correspond to the four basic functions. So, input, output, processing, or the CPU, and the secondary storage, hardware, or device. So, we start with the input device. So, si input, meron siyang keyboard, at meron din siyang source data entry device. So, dalawa po ang kanyang category. There are two categories for input, keyboard entry device, and source data entry device. So, ang keyboard, mostly yung kailangan nating mga keys. So, ang isa na dyan is the computer keyboard. Ano pa mga under sa keyboard entry device? Isa lang. Isa lang yung under sa kanya. Obviously, kasi keyboard kasi. So, computer keyboard. So, anong ibig sabihin ni computer keyboard? The most fundamental and widely used input device. So, there are different types of keyboard. Ito ay si projection keyboard. So, may projector siya dito, tapos lumalabas ng light, so nagka-project na siya. Si laptop keyboard, yung keyboard ay nakakonect sa laptop. si virtual keyboard, yung mga keyboard na nakikita natin sa cellphone. So, ang tawag doon ay virtual keyboard. Mechanical keyboard, ito. So, may mga different colors. Dito ay membrane keyboard. So, pag may nakita kayong keyboard na bakante ang gitna, that is a membrane keyboard. Multimedia or internet keyboard, this one, because, yes. Oh, this is a multimedia internet keyboard because meron siya mga pindutin dito for the internet. Hindi nyo naman kailangan i-click sa monitor, kundi may ipipindut lang dito sa ating keyboard at o diretso siya co-connect sa multimedia or the internet. That's why it's called multimedia or internet keyboard. This is a wireless keyboard because you don't need a wire. I-co-connect nyo lang po itong USB. Tapos, naga-bluetooth na yun silang dalawa. So, that is a wireless because there is a wire, obviously. No wire po siya. Kaya, wireless keyboard. And this one is the gaming. Pag lumalaro kayo ng mga Dota and everything, yung mga nasa computer, pwede po kayong gumamit nito. Mahal lang po yung gaming keyboard. This one is the ergonomic keyboard. Ang itsura nito, ha? This is an ergonomic keyboard. And this is a flexible keyboard. Bakit flexible? Kasi pwede mo lang siyang i-fold or i-round. That's why it's a flexible keyboard. Okay? Naka-rubber lang po siya. That's why pwede lang po siyang i-going circle. Okay? So, wait lang ha. Okay, next, we have is the source data entry device. So, sa source data entry device, meron tayong pointing devices and ano yun? Scanning devices. So, dalawa lang ba? So, dalawa lang yung ating device under the source data entry device, no? Mouse and the scanning device. So, si mouse, so, meron tayong left click button, right click button, and the scrolling wheel. Okay? So, meron tayong mechanical mouse. Yung itsura. Yung mechanical mouse, nasa baba yung ating ball. Pero mostly ngayon ay wala nang ginagamit na mechanical mouse. Laser na po. Like the optical mouse, ito yung mostly ginagamit natin. Nag-a-light po yan dito sa baba. And meron din tayong laser mouse. Yung parang see-through lang po yung sa baba niya. And unlike sa meron dito, diba? Like the keyboard, meron tayong pang gaming, meron din gawing gaming mouse. So meron yun sa side na pwede nating i-click-click for the mga command like for the defense, for the attacking command, mga ganyan. Okay, so we have the trackball. Trackball ang tawag dito because nandito po sa taas ang bola. And this is the left click and the right click. The stylus mouse, stylus no, kasi parang pencil po siya na pwede nyong isulat-sulat. So, that's what we call the stylus mouse. Presentation mouse, this is used for the overhead projector. Pwede po nyong during nag-present pa kayo using the projector, pwede po kayong mag-use ng laser pointer nyo to detect the mouse. I mean to highlight yung discuss nyo topic. Okay? The vertical mouse, ito yung vertical mouse. So, we're done with the mouse. So, next is the joystick. Ito yung joystick. Mostly, ito yung ginagamit for video games. Kasi you can do the left and right and then may mga keys yan dyan na pwede nyong, I mean, buttons na pwede nyong pindutin for some commands. So, touchscreen is also considered as a pointing device, ha? Take note of that. Bakit? Because instead of using a mouse, you're using your fingers. So, yung finger point nyo, ganyan. So, pinapoint nyo na siya. Obviously, pointing pointing device, the touchscreen. Digitizing tablet because this is where you write. For example, ngayon, no? Ito na yung mostly gusto ng mga teachers because they can use this as a whiteboard or blackboard for the online class. Kaso lang medyo mahal to. And mostly, pag kumukuha kayo ng ID sa school, diba, kay gumagamit po tayo nito for the signing of our signatures. Automatic, pumapasok po kaagad doon sa computer na naka-install nito. Touchpad, yung mouse na connected sa ating laptop. Ang tawag doon is a touchpad. So, next is the scanning device. So, barcode reader, ito. Automatic, no? Ipa-price tag niya lang, ganyan, sa supermarkets and malls, nakikita natin. Di na kailangan pa ni sales lady. Di na kailangan ni sales lady pa isulat ang every details of the item. So, just scan the using barcode reader, automatic lalabas na po yung name ng item and the price. Ito, used by the clerk. This is the MARC interface character recognition device. So, i-detect niya yung tawag dito. Wait lang ha, bakit bumaba to? So, i-scan niya yung mga print isa ating mga cheque. Okay? Si OMR, ito yun, no? Ginagamit yan where you vote for the presidents, barangay chairmans, and everything. So, ito yung ginagamit ngayon. Hindi na kailangan manually i-count. Automatic, yung mga in-answers natin, isi-scan niya lang. Ito yung ginagamit ang mga pang-board exam. Like yung sa future ninyo, no? Mag-board exam kayo. Yan na lang pang gagamitin. So, just do na klaro po yung ating fact sheets para ma-detect po ni computer. Kasi pag hindi ma-detect ni computer, wala po kayong answers doon. Kasi automatic na po siya, detect na lang po ng isang machine, not anymore by human being. The best example for this one is the, sino nagtataya ng loto dyan? O, di ba? Nag-shade tayo. Tapos, ipapasok na lang sa scanning device niya. Ang tawag doon is the OMR. OMR ang tawag doon, no? Optical Mark Recognition Device. Yung nag-scan sa ating lotto numbers. Okay? OCR naman, ito ay ginagamit wherein gusto mo ilagay sa ating computer yung may nabasa tayong text. Hindi na mo kailangan itatype natin yung isa-isa, no? Pwede na po yun using the OCR. Just scan it and then automatic po siya papasok sa computer. Yan po. Next is the fax machines. So, fax machines, mostly, medyo hindi na ito ginagamit, no? This is a telephone while meron po siya nag-print. Lumalabas yan wherein meron isang office na gusto mag-send ng letter through another office. Pero mostly kasi ngayon, because we're on the online, fax machine is all not already mostly used. Pwede kasi nag-email na sila mostly, no? Kesa sa fax machine. Kasi yung fax machine, matagal medyo mag-print pa sa email. Diretso na diretso ka agad doon sa sa ating email. So, we have also imaging system. If you want to have a photocopy or scan yung mga documents or pictures, kailangan mo ng imaging system or what we call the scanner. Card reader. Meron din tayong card reader. Ito yun na yung mga ATM machines. Yung scan nyo yung ID nyo, yung credit card, yung KCC loyalty card, yung SM Advantage card, yan. Kailangan nila yan dito. Pwede din tayong mga record siya. So, ito yung mga memory card na ginagamit natin, SD card, or yung ating pang-read ng ating SIM card. Yan. card reader ang tawag sa lahat niyan. Okay? Ilan na si voice recognition input devices, no? So, you need to record, this is voice recognizing. So, ibig sabihin, nire-recognize niya yung voice nyo. For example, if your house is a, meron siyang password key. Aside from the password key, meron ding i-recognize niya yung voice. So, ibig sabihin, sasabihin niya, for example, yung password open. Sasabihin niya, open. Pero pag parehas ang password, pero yung voice is not parehas, so, hindi po mag-o-open yung ating door. Okay? So, this is the voice recognition input device. Audio input devices, kukunin niya lang po yung inyong audio. Like your microphone, headset, yung karaoke natin, gusto natin kumanta. So, yun po. Audio input device yun. So, digital cameras, ito na, no? Pero mostly, ginagamit pa ito ng mga for mga pictures like mga weddings, mga ganyan. Pero may mga cellphones na naman mga high-end. Magaganda yung mga pixels. Like yung mga cellphones na Samsung S21. Yung mga tag 70,000, mga ganyan, 100,000 plus na cellphone. Yun. Pang digital cameras na talaga yung anyong picture. Kaso lang, pag wala yung cellphones na yun, so grabe talaga yung price. Okay? The last one is the sensor. So, what is the sensor? Sensor, ito yung mga nasa mall wherein nadidetect na yan kung may kumuha kayong item na hindi nabayaran. Yun po. Or, sensor doon sa ating mga airports, di ba? Mga terminals, pinapasok yung mga gamit. So, naga-sensor yun doon. Okay, so those are the input device. So, tingnan nyo, daming input, no? Now, we go to the output. So, the output device, meron siyang soft copy and hard copy. Ayan, balikan ko yung soft. Yung soft copy, ibig sabihin, they are outputting device na doon lang po sa loob na mababasa. I mean, soft copy lang po siya. Hindi po siya hard copy, yung na-print out. Kasi pag hard copy, print out ang tawag doon. So, si soft copy refers to an output that appears on screen or in audio or in voice form. While hard copy, it refers to the printed output in paper, film, or in other tangible format. Yan po ang different ni soft and in hard copy. Okay, si soft copy, so we have a display screen. So, meron po tayong display screen is usually called a monitor or simply a screen. Oh, meron tayong word na pixels. So, ito yung ating dots or picture elements. So, pag mas maganda yung picture mo, mas malaki yung pixels. Kasi pag blurred yung picture mo, yun ang sinasabi, pixelated po yung picture na yan. Because yung anyong pixels ay maliliit, kaya pag print or pag view sa ating sa ating computers ay pixelated siya or blurred na po yung ating pictures. So there are 8 types of monitor. Ito yung una, no, yung bulky yung sa likod. Kahit yung TV nga, di ba, yung dati is a bulky one. So, that is what we call the CRT or the cathode ray tube. Ito naman is the liquid. So, after the CRT, na-exist po si LCD or the liquid crystal display. After that, meron din tayong TFT monitors and the LED or the light emitting diode monitors. Kahit yung ating TV, no, may CRT tayo, may LCD at may LED. And the last one is the smart TV. Yung parang TV na siya na computer. Kasi you can connect it to the Wi-Fi and you can watch Netflix, YouTube, anything within the internet. Kaya nga sinawag na siyang smart TV. Okay, so we have the DLP and the touchscreen. Ito yung mostly meron tayo, no, sa ating mga cellphones. They are the touchscreen monitors. May mga laptop din na touch screen na pwede nating i-touch yung ating mga screens sa ating laptop. So we have the plasma screen monitors, the OLED or the organic light emitting diode monitors. So those are the different monitors. Now we go to the audio output device. So si audio output device, so ito ay isang klaseng output na wherein ang boses po natin ang titingnan. Awit lang ha. Okay, sorry for that, no? So, we're now on the audio. So, audio output device. So, we're talking about voice, no? So, kailangan natin output. Ibig sabihin, lumalabas. So, that will be your speakers, your headphones, or your earbuds. Yung headsets kasi is a combination of headphones and microphone. Yun ang itawag natin yung sa mga cellphones natin, no? Pwede natin kausapin siya kasi may built-in po siyang microphone. Pwede na din tayo makinig. So that is what we call the headsets. Kasi yung headphones ay pandinig lang po yun at saka yung earbuds. Parang output lang po yun. Hindi tayo magkasalita to insert our voice to the computer. Okay? So we're done with the soft copy. Now with the hard copy na tayo. Yung hard copy, ito na po yung kailangan nating papel or anything na tangible part. So meron po tayong printers. Ang isa dito ay the printer one, no? Ang printer ay mayroong impact and non-impact printers. So what are the print impact? Yung impact is the dot matrix and the line printer. At matagal po yung kanilang ink. Hindi po siya nawawala. Yung non-impact, they are the laser, inject, thermal, photo, platters. And mostly, nagpipate po yon in due time. Okay? Katulad yung mga resibo ni pag mag-withdraw tayo sa ATM machine o yung resibo sa ating pagbili sa mga SM, sa mga KCC malls. Mostly in due time nawawala to yung yung print nila sa papel. Nagiging blanco na lang siya. Because they use a thermal printers. Non-impact siya. Okay, so this is the dot matrix printer. So impact po to. And this one is a line printer, impact po din yan. Line printers, ito na yung binibigay sa atin sa mga board exams, may mga papel, at saka yung papel ng loto, yung saan tayo nag-shade. Yun po isang line printers. So, na non-impact printer, we have the laser printer, the inkjet printer, ito yung thermal printer, tingnan nyo. Mostly sa mga resibo yan. Photo printers, multi-function printer. Bakit multi-function? It's because you can photocopy, you can scan, you can print. Yun po yun, yung mga functions niya. Marami siyang functions ang printer na to. Kaya nga, mostly, pag bibili kayo ng mga printer, yun na po yung multi-functions. Pwede kayong mag-photocopy, pwede kayong mag-scan, pwede kayong mag-print. Mas maganda na yun. As one na lang po. Okay? So, we have also the platters. Ano tong platters? A platters is mas malaki konti sa printer. Kasi ang piniprint din nila is malalaking papel. Like the pen-based platters. Ito, mga drawing at ito. Dito naman yung mga tarpaulin. Ito baka blueprint ang piniprint dito. Yung mga blueprints sa bahay, sa building. And this one is the platters, yung mga tarpaulin, billboards na nakikita natin sa mga, di ba, malalaki yon. O pwede din, ito din ang ginagamit, yung pag-print ng inyong birthday or meron kayong tarpaulin for the birthday, for the welcoming home, mga ganyan, or for the wedding, mga ganyan. So, platters po yung ginagamit to print that big size paper. Okay, yun na po yun, no? Elaborate. So, gagawin nyo in your own words, explain the flow of the four basic functions. Ito na yun, i-discuss nyo. Tingnan natin, no, kung okay na ba. Ayan, lumabas na siya. So, you just type your answer. For example, for the input, like my keyboard, example, gagamitin nyo yung pag-type nyo sa inyong messenger. I use my keyboard in my cellphone. Anong tawag dun sa keyboard ng cellphone? O, hanapin niyo yung term na yun. Para hindi nyo sasabihin, the keyboard in my cellphone. Kasi may term po yung keyboard sa cellphones natin, sa touchscreen, okay? And then it will process and go to store it to my cellphone. Mga ganyan, sasabihin nyo, okay? After you explain, click next. So, practice next. So, look at the different pictures shown below. Tick if it's a software or hardware. So, 2 points po. And specify what each of the picture is used for. 3 points. For example, this one. What is this and what is it used for? Sabihin ko, this is a USB. And it is used for storing my files. So, yan. So, is this a hardware or software? Ano yan? Click nyo lang to. Choose lang dito. Software or hardware? So, tingnan nyo uli kung anong ibig sabihin ni software. Anong ibig sabihin ni hardware? Okay. So, marami yan dyan. So, just click it and type. And then, click submit. After you done, click submit. Okay? So, ganun lang po yung activity natin for the first part. Ngayon, we'll go to the unit 2. So, bear with me, ha. I still have 25 minutes, so paspasan ko lang kasi para parehas na kayo na, hindi tayo na delay sa topic. So CPU, central processing device or the storage device. So central processing device, meron lang po isa. And that is the CPU or central processing unit. So ganito yung itsura ng CPU, no? Pag ibaliktad natin, ganito po yan siya. May mga I don't know kung ilang pins yan meron si CPU. So, sa CPU ay mayroong siyang 5 basic components.
the control unit, arithmetic logic unit, the main storage, registers, and buses. O, kayo na po magbabasa sa mga definitions ni control unit, ha? It's self-explanatory. Take note, kasama yan sa ating quiz and final exam. And take note, we're done with the module 4, so wait for the quiz number 4. Okay? It can be given to you by Sunday or by next week. So just wait, magpo-post lang po ako sa Google Classroom. Sana hindi mag-error si Google Classroom na pinost ko last meeting yung quiz number 2 at lumabas pagka-morning ng Monday alas 7 ng gabi, alas 7 ng umaga. Ewan ko ano nangyari dun. Okay, so we have the main storage, the registers, and the buses. Wait lang na. So buses are the bundles of tiny wires that serve as the communication path between components of the CPU. Ayan. So, ito yung mga buses, no? So, skip ko lang yan, no? Babasahin nyo na yung mga buses. And so, with the factors that affect their performance. So, after the CPU, we have the secondary storage. Secondary ang tinawag sa kanya because it is known as the auxiliary or a separate storage outside the computer. So, yan. So, nandiyan yung mga data hierarchy, units of measurement. So, ngayon, no, terabyte na po tayo meron. Pero, actually, in my time, kilobytes pa lang kami hanggang naubutan ko si megabytes and the gigabytes. Pero ngayon, we're on the terabytes. I don't know if you abutan nyo pa yung kilobytes. Okay. So, there are different storage. Ang tawag sa una is magnetic tape. I don't know if there's still magnetic tape na ginagamit. So, ganito yung magnetic tape, no? Ito yung mga tapes dati. We watch our movie using the VHS tape. Ngayon, di na. Sa USB na lang or sa computer, sa YouTube, or pwede natin download sa computer, no? Or through Netflix and watching movies. Okay, next one, magnetic disk. So, itong tawag na magnetic disk. Magnetic disks are your hard disk and floppy disk or diskettes. I don't know if meron pa ba kayo ngayon, I don't know if ginagamit pa ba ito. This one, the floppy disk, yung blue, ang storage niya is only 1.2 KB ba yun? Ay, parang kilobytes lang ata yun siya. Ano nito? 1.44. Yan. Ang kanyang range is only 1.44 megabytes. Tingnan nyo, megabytes lang to 200 MB. Ngayon, hindi na po pwede yan. Pag yung USB mo hanggang MB lang na. Hindi talaga kasya kahit yung pictures. Kasi mas marami na mga cellphones ngayon. Ang pictures ay grabe yung mga pixels. So, mas malaki din yung kanyang storage. Okay? So, these are the different, bakit ang isa is C at isa ay K. Yan, no? See, this ay refers to optical media that can be removed. And this one, pag hard disk, letter K. Kasi hindi siya pwede tanggalin yung bilog. Yung bilog kasi ay ang tinatawag na disk. So, ito ay matanggal, so C po siya. Pag yung bilog ay nasa loob ng hard disk, so hard disk is nasa loob, yung bilog ay nasa loob ng hard na disk na ito. So, that is why it's already in K. Okay? So, we have the optical disk, no?
I don't know if you're still using this one. So, mga CD-ROM, CDs, yan. So, passing lang po tayo dyan, no? Ay, napapaba. Please read it, ha? Okay? Now, we'll go to the inside the computer case. So, ito yung importante. So, we call this one as computer case or chassis or tower. So, it's a metal enclosure that contains many of the other hardware components. Yan. Yung computer, tawag dito ay computer chassis, tower, or yung sa case. So, yan. Meron tayong front side. No? Yung front side, ang makikita natin CD-ROM. Future expansions, pwede din dito yung hard disk natin. So, pwede pong hanggang dalawang hard disk, pwede po tayong maglalagay. So, ito yung mga memory card slots, floppy drive A. Pero ngayon, pagbibili po tayo ng computer, desktop, ay wala na po tayong makikitang floppy drive na nilalagay. Bale, wala na pong laman ito. Kundi, naka-close lang po siya. Nandito yung power button natin. Nandito yung mga naga-blink-blink lights. Okay, so dito lumalabas yung ating yung init ng ating CPU. Kasi syempre pag pumapasok niya pag naga-on yan, naga-on din yung kanyang fan. Ito yung fan, no? So this is your power supply at my fan po yan. Tapos lumalabas po yung fan diyan, okay? Ito meron tayong mga USB ports. Yan. So, yung power supply, meron siyang cord to connect to the current. Siyempre, you need the current for it to functions. And these are the ports. So, later on, i-discuss ko itong mga ports na ito. Pag i-open yung sa side, may makita po kayong ganyan. At itong pong green, ay hanggang dito po yung green na yan. And that's what we call the motherboard. So, i-discuss ko yung motherboard. Okay, what is motherboard? Motherboard is the basis of your computer. Okay? It's the first component installed in the system unit and it holds all of the circuitry that ties the functions of the computer components together. Ayan, ito po yung motherboard. So we have the South Bridge and the North Bridge. How will you know where is the North Bridge or South Bridge? Ito po yung CPU socket. Dito po ninyo ini-install si CPU. So, yung malaking fan na dyan, malaking slot na dyan, like this one, yung malapit sa CPU socket, yan po ang tinatawag nating North Bridge. Tapos, hanapin nyo yung malaki din, or anything na flat, na square, yan po yung magiging South Bridge ninyo. Okay? Basta yung malapit is the North Bridge. Okay. So, what are the two bridges of the motherboard? So, North Bridge, connected directly to the CPU. Kaya nga, malapit siya sa CPU via the front side bus and is thus responsible for tasks that require the highest performance. So, si North Bridge requires highest task performance. While the South Bridge, so they implement the slower capabilities of the motherboard in a North Bridge-South Bridge chipset computer architecture. Si South Bridge is named Internet Input-Output Controller Hub. While the North Bridge is named as the Memory Controller Hub or Graphics and Memory Controller Hub. Okay? Take note of that. Oh, wait. Eksama pa pala itong si External Memory and Controller Hub. Oh, wait. May nakasama. MCH lang pala. Okay. Okay, so there are two bridge in motherboard, ah. North Bridge and the South Bridge. Oh, yan, basahin nyo na lang yan. Passing lang ako because it's already 10:45. I still have 15 minutes more. So yan, yung ating motherboard. So, ito yung CPU socket. So yung malaki must be the North Bridge, okay? And then, hanapin yung square. So, yung square dito, which is this one, that will be your South Bridge. Ayan. So,
aside from the motherboards, meron din tayong ibang computer peripherals wherein hindi po siya connected sa ating computer at kailangan nating bilhin. One is the power supply. We need a UPS, which is an interruptible power supply, and an ABR, which is an automatic voltage regulator. Bakit kailangan yun ng ABR? Kaya nga, mostly nasisira yung ating mga appliances, especially ating computer, is because of the unregulated voltage. Yung patas, biglang tumataas yung ating voltahe o bumababa ang ating voltahe. So, kailangan mo si ABR para kahit tumataas o bumababa yung voltahe natin, eh nagbibigay pa rin siya ng regulated voltage. Wala siyang pakialam kung tumataas o bumaba, basta meron kang ABR. And yung UPS naman, kailangan po natin yan because, for example, nag-brown out. Hindi, kasi ang desktop kasi is not like a laptop. Pag naka-charge yan, kahit mag-brown out yan, magagamit mo at mag-turn off mo yung computer safely. Unlike sa desktop, pag wala kang UPS, pag mag-brown out, magko-close yung ating computer. At medyo, this will be one of the causes na sisira yung ating computers. So that's why meron kayong, kailangan nating bumili ng UPS because it will give us 5 to 30 minutes to save our computer. I mean, our files and turn off our computer properly. Okay. So, kailangan natin si UPS and the ABR. So, ano pa yung special type of processor chips? Meron tayong Matco processor chips. Yan. Makikita natin yan sa motherboard na naka-install na siya. And so, with this one, and the system clock, ito din. Makikita na natin yan sa ating motherboard, the RAM, which is the DRAM and the SRAM. So, yung difference ng SRAM and DRAM, read it na lang, no? Basahin niyo because it's self-explanatory and for your additional knowledge or information. And this one is the ROM chips. Ngayon, what is a bus line? A bus line is that facilitate the transfer of data between several devices located between two endpoints. Only one device is being able to transmit data at a given moment. So, itong mga wires, yan po yung bus line. Nakikita po natin, wait, lalaki konti. Para makita ninyo. Yeah. Yan. Yung mga... yung mga green dito, that is the bus lines. So, dyan po yung dumadaan yung mga datas natin, mga kuryente, and etc. That's why when you're checking your motherboards, and this is the motherboard actually, ha. Bale, kinuha ko lang yung portion ni motherboard para ipakita sa inyo yung mga bus lines. So, yung mga point-point dyan, so we don't know ano po yung mga point-point. Perhaps that's a terminal sa isang data. So, dumadaan yung mga datas natin, pupunta sa everything, kung saan ba yung pupunta, and the current. That's why kailangan mo, pag-check tayo ng ating motherboard, kailangan mo din ng multi-tester. Okay. Aside from motherboards, we have the ports. Ang ports ay pwede pong nating makita yan sa likod ng computer chassis, di ba? Sinabi ko kanina, i-discuss ko yan later on. So, this is a connector on the device to which cables for other devices are attached. For example, the PS2 mouse, a PS2 port. This is the for the keyboard and this is for the mouse. Okay? Ngayon, itong USB, dyan nilalagay yung USB natin. Ito for the internet or in the connection, internet LAN port or the local area network. Kukunin natin yung mga different computers na connected sa hub or through direct sa ating internet. Kasi ang desktop po, unlike sa ating mga cellphones and laptop, meron po silang Wi-Fi. Pero ang computer po nating desktop ay wala pong Wi-Fi, so kailangan po natin ng wire to connect this one. Okay? So these two is the parallel and serial communication ports. Nung dating mga printers, ito po yung ginagamit, ang kanilang connection. Pero ngayon, yung mga printers natin, USB na po yung kanilang cord.
So we can directly connect it to the USB port. And this one is for the BGA port. Kino-connect po yan sa ating monitor or screen or diretso po sa projector para mas malaki po yung ating yung during pag-report-report, yung dito po natin kono-connect ang ating projector. Okay, so this is for the speakers, the microphones, and this one is for the gaming device. Okay, so nandito po yung different ports din. So please read it in your for your own information, ha, para you have an idea. Okay, we have also the video and sound card. Yan. Ito yung kailangan natin pag gusto nating mas maganda yung ating graphics sa computer. Kasi minsan kasi pag lumalaro po tayo ng mga games at malalaki po ang kanilang mga videos, so you need to install higher video and sound cards. So ito na yun, no? So ito yung mga video cards. So meron siyang heatsink na connected sa kanya kasi minsan pag nalaro tayo ay naiinitan. So meron siyang automatic na para pampa-cool down sa ating cards. Okay. Last is the local area network. Ay, salamat. Natapos na din tayo sa ating last topic. Okay, the local area network, ito na yon. So, kailangan mo din ng gito for you to connect sa internet and through the network, computer network. So, later on, baka sabihin nyo, ano kayo sinasabi ni ma'am computer network? So, actually, meron tayong topics dyan. Baka by next meeting, yun na yung computer network na i-discuss ko. So, silan, ito ay diniscuss ko lang muna yung mga different device. Later on, doon na tayo sa ating computer network. Okay, so kailangan natin to for us to connect to different computers and connect to ourselves to the internet. So, we're done with our topic in Module 4. So, you wait for the quiz for Module 4. So, the same pa rin, no? It can be fill in the blank or multiple choice type of quiz. So, yung quiz 4 will be about Module 4. So, you wait for me until Sunday. Pag walang natakpuan sa Sunday, ibig sabihin baka next week. So, kasi medyo mayroon din akong ibang klase na ginagawa din yung mga activities nila. Okay. So, yung Google Slides, so give me time for it to select for the topics, no? So, the Module 4, meron din po tayong laboratory dito. Pero yung laboratory, since almost all of you doesn't have a computer or laptop at home, so nag-isip na lang ako ng ibang laboratory. So, ang gagawin ninyo, so ida-download ko to, no? I mean, gagawin ko to sa Google Form. So, ang gagawin nyo lang, for example, ipakita ko ito, so sasabihin nyo kung ano to. So, nandun po yung nandito po, ito po yung magiging guide ninyo kung ano po yung magiging answers nyo dito. So, itatype nyo lang po yung answers dyan. Regarding dito, nandito yung kanyang word. So, that is the matching games. Ngayon, exercise number 2, wherein you're going to use this one and complete the sentence. For example, she's going to take the pictures with the. O, hanapin natin. Printer ba? Keyboard, mouse, calculator, speaker, radio, computer, camera, cellphone, or memory card. Ang pinaka malapit is the camera or yung cellphone naman, meron naman yung camera. So, titingnan nyo baka meron pa dyang phrase or sentence na cellphone yung answer. Okay? So, itatype ko dito, then fill up nyo lang ito. And then this one, anong nangyari dito? So, this will be ang ilalagay nyo kung dito, kung sample, siya ay isang input ba, output, storage, processing, or computer system. What do you mean by computer system? Ang computer system is, meron kasi dito ay computer system siya. It consists of input, output, storage, and process. Yun po yung computer system. Ah, take note, computer system is a combination of all the four, input, output, storage, and process. Pero pag input lang siya, sulat nyo po dito, I. Pero pag output, yung O. Pero pag si mouse is S, storage at si mouse or processing. Hindi kaya computer system. So CS ilalagay natin. So ilalagay ko muna yan sa Google Forms, okay? And we have also ito pang last. Okay, itong last. Bale, tatlong activity lang for the computer hardware. So last one is the computer hardware crossword puzzle. So kayo po magtitink kung ano ito. For example, ito. 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 alphabets for the 15. Ano kaya to? Bakit 5 lang? Is this CPU? CPU is tatlo lang. So hanap po kayo ng another pattern for this one for you to write here sa salaob ng ating crossword puzzles. Okay? So that's the end of our module 4. So any questions tayo dyan? Question tayo. I guess silence means sis. Ah, Sally,
none
yes.
So far, ma'am.
Ah, none, okay.
None, so, ma'am.
None, ma'am. None so far, ma'am.
Ah, okay. None so far, ma'am. Okay, so I'm ending our class. So please open your camera for my documentations in our meeting. Okay, 1, 2, 3, smile. Ay, isa pa. 1, 2, 3. Wait lang. 1, 2, 3. Wait, sorry. Smile. Okay, class. Thank you for your time, ha? So, kung bakante pa kayo, you can do your activities na sa Google Docs and Sheets. Or your activities for the hardware. May na-upload naman nyo yung kagabi. Okay, so, thank you guys for your time. Stay safe and God bless. Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you.